In this video, we're going to build a pivot table with bars and KPI indicators. So notice that these two columns are a part of our pivot table. They're not separate formulas. And all of this is based on our data here, right in this tab. And also we have our goal for each salesperson here. Right now, it's set to $850,000, as you can see. And here, we can see which people reached that goal right here. Now, I could go back and change that amount. So if I change that to 900,000 and go back and look at our pivot table, we'll see that it will update. And you can see the only person that reached this goal is this person right here. And then we can also see this progress bar that shows how far the rest of our salespeople are from reaching the actual goal. So let's get right to it. So I'm going to get started with my data. As you can see, we have some sales amounts here in this column G, and we have some sales reps here. That's pretty much all the data I'm going to use for my pivot table. So what I'll do, I'll just create a pivot table from this. New worksheet is fine. And I'm gonna add sales in our values. And I'll do sales rep in rows. So far I got this. So what I'm gonna do for now, I'm gonna build some formulas next to my pivot table. So let's start with a Spark line. So here, if I open the help, see there is this nice option list for chart type bar and max 50. That's exactly what I'm going to need in a second. So I'm going to copy that. For data, I'm going to click on this amount, comma. Then I'm going to paste those options that I just copied from here. Close parentheses, hit enter. So right now it makes a bar. And what it does as a size for this bar, it's gonna use this 50 max. Now for that 50, I'm gonna use our goal. So let's say that would be 850,000. I'm gonna hit enter. And now if I take this and drag it down, you'll see the ones that reached that number, they will basically just have the whole bar full. And the other ones that didn't, it will basically just show how much of it is done. So the problem with this formula is going to be that we want this formula to also work here. So I don't want this in this line. So I need to do some sort of handling to make sure that when we're in this grand total line, we don't do this graph. So the way we're going to handle that, we're going to go up here and we're going to add an if statement. So I'm going to go ahead and cut this formula without the equal sign so I can paste it in just a second. I'm going to start with an if statement. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to check if this amount equals our grand total. And the way I'm going to get that grand total is by simply doing a sum from our source data, sales amounts. So I'll go sum, go to my source data, select this whole column G. That's what I want to sum. Close parentheses. So I'm saying if that amount equals to the total, comma, then I want to leave it blank. So I'm going to do double quotes, comma. Otherwise, in all the other cases, I want to actually do that Spark line. So I'm going to paste that Spark line formula here, close parentheses again, and hit enter. And it should look the same, only now if I drag this formula like this, see, this cell remains empty. So one last modification I want to do to this, I want to make sure that I don't hard code my number here. So instead what I'll do, I'll create another tab and I'm gonna call this inputs. And here I'll just do our goal, 850,000. Maybe we'll just format this too. And now I'll go back to my formula here, and instead of typing this 850,000 here, we'll replace it with a reference to that cell in this inputs tab. So I'm gonna go to inputs and click on this 850,000 right there. I'm gonna hit enter. If I want this formula to work when I drag this down, I wanna make sure this reference is absolute so it doesn't move. So I'm gonna select that and press F4 to add those dollar signs, hit enter. And now if I drag this down, we should have a working formula that's basically based on this amount. So one thing we might want to change about this is the color of this. So maybe you don't like this orange color. So what we can do here, we can go to this options list. Inside of these brackets, I'm gonna add another semicolon and provide color 1, comma, and then give it a value after the comma. Like for example, red. See, that would color code this in red. Now, if you want a particular color, you can just go here and pick a color. You can pick one of these colors, or maybe you have some custom color in mind. You can go under this custom and basically just pick whatever color you want. Once you got the color, just grab this hex number, copy that, and we're gonna go back and replace this red with that particular hex color, like that. And now if I drag this down, that should use that color. Let's get rid of this. So this is now our sparkline formula. So I'm just gonna copy that formula, the whole thing. Now, the only thing we wanna remember in this formula is right now we refer to this B2 cell, which is the cell to the left. So I'm gonna clear this. And I'm gonna go back to my pivot table now. I'm gonna add another value field. And this time we're gonna create a calculated field. And in this calculated field, we're gonna choose custom and we're gonna paste our formula we just did. Now, if you remember, we got this B2s here. B2s used to refer to the cell. What we need to do, we need to replace those B2s with the actual calculation here. And this total amount, it's the sum of this column right here. In our data, it's called sales. So I'm gonna go here, instead of B2, I'm gonna do sum, open, close parentheses, and in parentheses, I'm gonna do sales. Now, if your field has spaces, you need to put that in single quotations like this. Mine doesn't, so I'm just gonna do sales. Now the same thing we need to do, the sum sales, I'm gonna copy that with our second B2 that's over here. So I'm gonna select that B2, paste that sum sales, hit enter. Let's try to zoom in a little bit. And now we should have this formula that gets us what we need. We don't have here anything because it checks against this total and they match. So it keeps it blank like it should. And in all the other cases, we do this sparkline formula right here. So that's the same formula, except that instead of that B2, which was just a reference, I replace it with a sum of sales, which is this field right there. Now we need another one that's basically gonna give us a checkbox if that person reached the goal. So for that, we're gonna do another if formula. So we're gonna need actually a couple of if formulas on this, because for one of them, we still wanna check if it's grand total. We don't wanna put anything in here. So for that reason, I'm gonna use ifs function here. And I'm gonna say, if this equals, again, sum of our sales amounts from our original data, from here, G column, close parentheses, comma, then I wanna leave this blank. So double quotes, comma. Then we need our second condition. So for my second condition, I wanna check, let's go to that pivot table. I wanna check if this amount is greater than or equal to our goal. So I'm gonna check if this is greater than or equal the goal we have. Our goal is located on our input tab. So I'm gonna go to input, click on this amount. And again, I'm going to press F4 to make this absolute reference. So if that has reached that goal, comma, then for now, I'm just going to put an X here in quotes, comma. And finally, in all the other cases, I'm just going to leave this blank. So I'm going to say true, which is all the other cases, comma. Then you could put a different thing here, right? You could say like no or something. So if I do this, close parentheses, and hit enter, so I can show you what happens. See, we got an X here. And if I drag this formula down until here, basically we have our X's in all these cases and no's for the rest. Now, I don't want these no's. So I'm going to just do that, replace that no with nothing. And now if I drag this down, it's basically just going to have X's. Now, finally, I don't want an X. I want something that will give me like a check. So for that, what I'll do, I'll go to Google Docs, an empty document, and I'm going to go under Insert and do Special Characters. And in this Special Characters list, we're going to go find something for this. So I'll just do check or something. Let's see. So see, we can use this, any of these is fine. I'm going to use this particular checkbox on this. But again, you could grab anything you like. If I click on that, see, that puts that box here. I'm going to copy that character. Control C, Command C, go back here. And I'm going to go back to my formula. And instead of this X, I'm just going to paste that character. And if I hit enter and drag it down, we'll see how this works. Basically, we got our character here. So again, now that we got this formula, we're going to basically place this inside of our pivot table. So I'm going to go ahead and copy that formula, erase all of this, click on this pivot table, and we're going to basically add another value field. I'm going to click add and do another calculated field. And again, we're going to use custom. I'm going to again paste that formula here. And one more time, all of these B2s should be now referring to this amount right here, which is going to be, again, sum of that field, which in my case, the field is sales. So that's what I'm going to do. Now I have two of these. So I'm going to copy the sum of sales, Control C, Command C, go right until I find this other B2. And I'm going to paste that one too. So I'm going to override both of these. Hit enter. Now I should have that built in to my pivot table. So at this point, I can rename these column names. Simply just type right over the column. And then for these, I'm just going to select this column and we'll just center like that. Maybe we'll make this column smaller and select this headers. Go on top here and use wrap text. Maybe a little bigger for this column name. If I want to redo the way my pivot table looks overall, I could go to format and do this first option here and choose one of these, maybe. I'm going to leave this up to you. You can customize it, make it look nicer if you wanted to. Now for me, what I'm going to do, I'm just going to make this headers a little smaller and align them vertically and horizontally. And finally, if you want, you can also add a little bit of color coding to these cells too. I could select this column here, go to format and do conditional formatting. And for these, I'm going to go here and choose text is exactly. And as a value, I'm basically just going to go back to that same character and copy it and come back and paste it here. So now I can choose some format for these. Maybe make it bold, press done. And there we go. Now we have this entire thing built into our pivot table. And that should do it. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe. And I'll see you in the next video.